Hi, let's discuss the laryngeal neurovasculature. In this video, we'll discuss the arteries and nerves that serve the larynx and explain the specific targets of each nerve and its branches. But let's start with the vasculature. There are two arteries which serve the larynx, the superior laryngeal artery and the inferior laryngeal artery. Let's take a look at where they come from. So as we follow the superior laryngeal artery's path, we see that it arises from the superior thyroid artery. That superior thyroid artery is a branch of the external carotid artery, a major artery which supplies the neck, face, and head with blood. So the superior thyroid gives off the superior laryngeal artery. That superior laryngeal artery, it's transmitted through the thyrohyoid membrane deep. It's accompanied by the internal branch of the superior laryngeal nerve, which we'll discuss shortly. The inferior laryngeal artery is a branch of the inferior thyroid artery. That inferior thyroid artery is a branch of the thyrocervical trunk, which arises from the first part of the subclavian artery. So from subclavian artery, we have the thyrocervical trunk, which gives rise to several branches, among them the inferior thyroid. And it's the inferior thyroid artery that gives rise to the inferior laryngeal artery. So a laryngeal artery is always supplied by its commensurately named thyroid artery. Superior thyroid gives rise to the superior laryngeal. Inferior thyroid gives rise to the inferior laryngeal. In terms of innervation, the larynx is exclusively innervated by the vagus nerve. High in the carotid sheath, the vagus nerve gives off the superior laryngeal nerve. That superior laryngeal nerve descends within the carotid sheath, and it branches into the internal branch and the external branch. The internal branch is somatic sensory. It's also secretomotor to the mucosa that are superior or proximal to the vocal folds. The external branch is somatomotor or efferent to the cricothyroid muscle. That cricothyroid muscle controls the cricothyroid joint. When it tips, it puts tension on the vocal folds to increase pitch. So that's all complements of the external branch of the superior laryngeal nerve. When I think about the two of these things, what comes to mind is that I am sensitive on the inside, and I am muscular on the outside. Anyhow, the other contribution of the vagus nerve to the larynx comes by way of the recurrent laryngeal nerve. The recurrent laryngeal nerves branch from the vagus. On the right side, the recurrent laryngeal nerve wraps around the subclavian artery at the root of the neck. On the left side, the recurrent laryngeal nerve wraps around the concavity of the aorta. On both sides, they ascend the neck in the tracheoesophageal groove, paired with the inferior laryngeal artery. Some folks call the recurrent laryngeal nerve beyond the cricoid margin the inferior laryngeal nerve, but more often than not, it's referred to as the recurrent laryngeal nerve throughout its course. The recurrent laryngeal nerve is efferent to all of the intrinsic laryngeal muscles, with the exception of our good friend cricothyroid here. It's also somatic sensory from, afferent from, as well as secretomotor to the mucosa distal below the vocal folds or inferior to the vocal folds. So in terms of somatic sensory and secretomotor, internal branch of superior laryngeal is above the vocal folds, recurrent laryngeal below the vocal folds. So we've discussed The role of the various branches of the vagus nerve, both superior laryngeal nerve and its external and internal branches, as well as the recurrent laryngeal nerve, to the larynx, both somatic motor, somatic sensory, as well as visceral motor. Thank you very much for your time. This is your summary slide.